What's up, Steezy fam, and what's up, everybody else? There's two kinds of people here, right? There's two kinds of people. There's Steezy fam, and there's everybody else. Well, I guess those could be Swifties or just randos, you know? Random people. But as I say in some of my videos, it's been a little while, and it's good to be back, and I missed you. I don't know if I say I've missed you, but I should say that because if I didn't, I wouldn't be back, right? I miss this and I miss you guys. Anyway, it's time for another Taylor Swift video. I'm still working on Evermore. So this is a little disclaimer here. I sort of heard this song. I was hanging out with a friend, and I think they played it on their phone. And I intentionally kind of tried not to listen because, well, one, it was already hard to listen. It was pretty windy. And it was just off the phone, so it wasn't really, able to compete with the wind or whatnot. So it wasn't too hard not to listen. But I really tried to save myself for this video and for you guys. So this is basically a completely fresh reaction. I basically haven't heard this song. I mean, I've technically heard it, like the noises that make up this song have made it to my ear. But I don't remember anything, really. I don't. And I certainly wouldn't recognize it if I heard it. Except for maybe after this video is made, because I will have heard it by the time that you've seen this video. Yeah, let's just do it like we do it and hit that play button, and I will let you guys know what I think. This is another intro that kind of reminds me of the Postal Service a little bit. I think I've said this about another song of hers, or certainly another video I did.
Honey, when I'm above the trees, I see this for what it is. But now I'm right down in it. All the years I've given is just shit we're dividing up. Showed you all of my hiding spots. I was dancing when the music stopped. And in the disbelief, I can't face reinvention. I haven't met the new me yet.
Like that idea of not having met the new me yet. She has a nice way of just painting a picture really quickly sometimes, like zooming in or zooming out. Just in a few sentences, tastefully describes like a scenery and a mood, a time maybe. There's a lot of context that can be expressed in a few lines, and she really makes use of that. I don't know if you guys heard a little notification noise or something. I actually almost never have my phone next to me when I'm doing these videos. Who texted me at 5:12 in the morning? Oh, somebody in Florida. Not gonna read that. I'm just gonna mute my phone real quick. Normally I'd edit this video out, but something about editing parts out of a video that is reaction based doesn't seem very genuine. So you can just appreciate the awkwardness with me a little bit. Yeah, let's keep listening. I'm following the story.
There'll be happiness after you, but there was happiness because of you.
Huh. Have you ever found yourself having to tell you or tell yourself these kinds of things? I think most of us have. I know I have.
Both of these things can be true. There is happiness past the blood and bruise, past the curses and cries, beyond the terror in the nightfall. Haunted by the look in my eyes that would have loved you for a lifetime. Leave it all behind, and there is happiness. Tell me, when did your winning smile begin to look like a smirk? When did all our lives? and start to look like weapons pointed at my deepest hurt. I hope she'll be a beautiful fool who takes my spot next to you. No, I didn't mean that. Sorry, I can't see facts through all of my fury. You haven't met the new me yet.
Huh. Oh, that sounds like, well, now I'm both intrigued but a little bit confused by this idea of the new me yet. Is she the new me now? Oh man, no. There's so many things that this could mean. I feel like I don't even want to jump into speculating it too much.
There'll be happiness after me, but there was happiness because of me.
Ah, funny. I was just thinking in my head, like, I didn't expect that, what was it she just said? Sorry. the new me, yeah, the concept of the new me thing. I didn't really expect that to circle around again. I don't know why, it just didn't feel like the kind of thing that would, but this, I guess this would be the chorus. Obviously it would circle around again, so I guess I'm not too surprised about that, but then there's the perspective flip. Trippy stuff, but it's good.
There'll be happiness after me, but there was happiness because of me. Both of these things, I believe there is happiness in our history across a great divide. A glorious sunrise, dappled with the flickers of light from the dress I wore at midnight. Leave it all behind, and there is happiness. I can't.
This song really just feels like a poem to me. I think the music kind of allows for this to be expressed in a way that feels very poetic, and it just kind of makes it more obvious that this song is very poetic in a lot of ways. A lot of songs are very musical and it feels like a song, but this one feels more like a poem to me. Something about the patterns and the turnaround and flips of perspective and stuff, and I think rhythmically even, I feel like the style and the structure of the story and the lyrics is really kind of dictating the music. A lot of the times I think about what's driving the song, and generally I think about it in a musical way. Like, what is musically driving this song? Is it the guitar? Is it the bass line or the drums? Or what is it really? Or sometimes it's the vocals, like everything plays a background role. But I feel like everything's kind of playing a background role to the concept and structure of this very poetic. It's a very poetic song, I guess. Technically it's a song, right? But it just, again, it feels super poetic the way that it's all laid out here. And that's cool. That's cool. It's also cool to know that the Taylor Swift, I mean, I kind of expect it now almost, that the Taylor Swift audience would appreciate the poetry of all this lyricism. Because again, I just really didn't expect that going into this. But after I've been more or less kind of conditioned, and my expectations have been changed completely after listening to Folklore and what I've heard of Evermore now. Yeah. It's not too surprising, I guess. And I just wonder how many people out there have this impression of Taylor Swift of being like a really... I know this album stands out. Like, it's a little bit different than the rest of her work. And I kind of just get that. I just get that from listening to it, but also from pretty much what everybody says that is probably more qualified as a fan or a longtime fan or a Swiftie or whatever that says that. But yeah, I just wonder how many people out there really get that. Anyway, I'll keep listening. I was just also thinking too about like how this song, a lot of breakup songs or whatever. I'm not saying that this is one of those, but they always focus on the perspective of the pain or something like this, but this one, or maybe, you know, sometimes you get the one that sort of focuses on the positive, but this one is really like, It seems so far, at least, that it's very back and forth, and I actually think that that's probably. Well, I don't know if I was going to say that's the most realistic, because I think it depends on how the relationship ended or whatnot, but I think in some regard it's always back and forth. Like there's some spite. Like there's a party that really wants the best for them because you still care about them and you know they're a good person deep down. And there's also a party that just doesn't want to be that like bitter, spiteful, jealous person, right? So you kind of resist. You resist those impulses of revenge and whatnot. But there's also a genuine part of you that's like hurt and is jealous, and you know, the part that does want the best for them and whatnot. Yeah, it's a real emotional mess to navigate through. And this is a cool song expressing that. Yeah, because a lot of songs are very surface level. You know, just expressing like the most basic and generic like versions of pain that you might feel in a relationship, like the same crap every song has ever said. This is definitely not one of those. It's this one kind of takes a middle ground of something that isn't explicitly this way or that way, but at the same time, there's a lot of depth in that middle ground. And I think this song, yeah, complements that very nicely in the way that it's structured, but also the content of the lyrics as well. Man, that was a long tangent. I feel like pressured now to just hit that play button, but I think I made my point. That might be the longest tangent I've ever taken. It feels that way. Damn. I love the maturity of this song. That's, I think, really what gets me in this song, is the maturity that it shows. I think if you're growing as a person and you've had to navigate through a lot of challenging perspectives that are fueled so often by like other people's thoughts and you know, emotions that are at an intensity that you've never felt before. It can be really difficult to come back around and still feel like yourself at the end of it, you know? And I love that line, or I guess a couple of these lines. No one teaches you what to do when a good man hurts you. Because it does seem like a paradox. You're angry, you take it personally, and there's a side of you that wants to react to that, and then there's the other side that knows, but this person is good, and I know that they're good. So ultimately, you have to kind of remove yourself from the equation, and I think that's the hardest part of splitting up. And totally right. No one teaches you what to do, but I guess life teaches you, right? Life teaches you a lot of things, but it's kind of up to you to decide what the lesson is, and if you want to actually go through it or acknowledge it. And obviously, sometimes there's just a level of like intelligence or maturity that is a part of the equation as well. Like, are you even capable of understanding what this lesson is? Or is it one of those things that you realize like 5 or 6 years later, like, oh, you know, this is why this happened or whatever. Yeah. Really cool song. Again, the maturity is really what speaks to me in this one. The paradox and the maturity. It's so good. I think this song is so healthy for people, as opposed to just the classic, like, just the stupid breakup songs, dude. There's so many stupid fucking breakup songs, and this is not one of those. This is one of the complete opposites, and it's great to see that this exists in front of such a large following. Because obviously Taylor Swift is one of the most like famous people and musicians of all time, I would say. Like musicians of all time and people probably, like at least now. I mean, Jesus, how many people would you have to ask, who is Taylor Swift? Like, and get somebody that genuinely has no idea. Be a lot of people.
A good man hurts you, and you know. and you know you hurt him too. Honey, when I'm above the trees, I see you for what it is. But now my eyes leak acid rain on the pillow where you used to lay your head. After giving you the best I had, tell me what to give after that. All you want from me now is the green light of forgiveness. You haven't met the new me yet.
Yeah, the green light of forgiveness, huh? It's a great song. Dude, the lyricism in here, wow, it's really, really good. I forget what I was reading or hearing the other day, but it was talking about something, and I guess the end of the story was that this person finally got the closure that they needed to see that this person was okay, which gave her permission to move on. I think it's some story about like a daughter that like ran away from her house because her mother was just a toxic, poisonous, miserable person, and she basically completely cut her out of her life. Like the daughter decided to cut the mother out of her life completely. But there was always this guilt inside of having cut your mother out. Like, you don't really know if she's okay. Like, there's a party that kind of wants to forgive her because you know that for some reason, like, she's all fucked up in the head and it's like probably not totally her fault or something, but you know you can't be there and you have to get out. But there's always this guilt. And so I guess this daughter, if I'm telling the story correctly, got a phone call from the family or something from the house that she left one day and talked to her mom for the first time in a long time, and her mom sounded like okay. She sounded happy, she sounded better, and they didn't really talk about anything directly, but just the fact that she felt like her mom was okay gave her, the daughter, permission to kind of let go and permission to like forgive and ultimately put all that guilt down. So that's another really good line right here. Tell me what to give after that.
All you want from me.
Yeah, all you want from me now is the green light of forgiveness.
Now is the green light of forgiveness.
Yeah, geez, that's the other tough part. Yeah, that's the other part. Like when I think that's one of the struggles of being a good person, so to speak, is the part where you just feel bad. You feel bad. And you're looking for something that'll help you not feel bad. That's so weird to put it that way, though. All you want from me now is that green light of forgiveness. Damn. In the end, is that all it really boils down to, or something? I mean, yes and no. And I think just poetically, it's a really cool way to put that. That's a very cool lyric, though.
Happiness because of you too. Both of these things can be true. There is happiness in our history across our great divide. There is a glorious sunrise dappled with the flickers of light from the dress I wore at midnight.
That was a fantastic story, song, poem, whatever you want to call it. I loved that. That was really good. I haven't listened to anything Taylor Swift, I think, in a while. Maybe something played in the background. I was playing tennis with a buddy of mine the other day, and he played some music, and I think some Taylor Swift song off of Evermore or Folklore came on. And every now and then I still hear Willow playing somewhere. And if it were for this channel, I honestly don't think I'd know what that song was or who it was by. I just wouldn't. Because I kind of make a point to not really pay attention to what's on the radio. Because most of it kind of sucks, dude. It really, I think it really does. And I could just, whatever, because I'm ignorant or whatever, because I don't listen to it, so I don't really know what's on there. But I think for the most part, it just kind of does. And I don't know. There's a reason I don't listen to it, and I haven't for a long time. But I did go out of my way to make this channel and somehow stumbled upon this song and the following that Taylor Swift has, which has, I guess, become a little bit of my following as well. And it's great. It's really cool. But damn, what a song. Wow. The maturity of it is so cool. And I feel like this song leaves me feeling exactly like I should. If I'm really trying to relate to the song, like, there's parts of me where I really feel the sadness and the tragedy of something so special ending, but also that just exhausting struggle of how back and forth you can be with, like, just dealing with the pain and maybe even the anger. I think that's the thing, is like the pain can just eventually turn into anger. You, like, you start to just resent how you feel, and that's either going to be pointed at the relationship or at the person, maybe even yourself. But if you leave all that behind, there is happiness because, yeah, the history and whatnot. But again, when you're really able to remove yourself from a lot of that stuff and be above the trees, so to speak, yeah, there is happiness. I've talked about this before in another song about how happiness, I think, is maybe this misunderstood concept, or was that some other conversation I had? I'm not sure, but yeah, I think it was here. I talked about the difference between happiness and presence. Yeah. Well, that was a really good song. I wonder if I have another one in me. I don't know. You know, I usually try to do a couple at a time when I do this one, but I feel like I'm just going to do that one and call it for now because I don't know. It was kind of a lot to go through all that. and I can feel, it'd just feel weird to go into the next song, I guess. Kind of want to soak this one in a little bit or something, but I know the album is structured in such a way where if you listen from song to song, I mean, if it's structured like a proper album, it would kind of move appropriately from one track to the next. But I'm not really listening to things in order, and I feel the way that I feel anyway. But damn, yeah, what is, I wonder what the next track after Happiness is. I guess we'll see if that's the next one I listen to and react to. But for now, I'm just going to take a quick break, and you guys will see this when it's up and it's cleared of any copyright issues, which does happen sometimes and just takes a give or take a couple days or so to dispute. Anyway, thanks for sitting here and hanging out through all those tangents. That was definitely really fun and cool for me to go through. And again, that's just such a good song. I feel like Taylor Swift really, or like maybe her audience, I would say, really grows with her if this is the kind of stuff she's coming out with. Like, I kind of imagine in my head, like, a whole audience kind of maturing alongside the creator. Yeah. And if that's one of the things that keeps Taylor Swift relevant, at the level of fame that she's had for this long, like, that's so cool. That's really, really cool. All right. Well, that's all for now. Really good having you guys here for this video, and I will see you in the next one. Please like and subscribe because I definitely want to be growing this channel a little bit. It's a fun thing to be working on. And yeah, if you guys like the content, please show your support by liking and subscribing, and I will see you guys in future videos, and I will see you guys in the comment section as well. Yeah. All right. That's all for now. Bye.